עובר שם ישבנו גם בחינו בזוכרנו את ציון על ערבים בתוכה תלינו כינורותינו כי שם שלונו שובנו דברי שיר ותוללנו שמחה שירו לנו משיר ציון איך נשיר את שיר השם על עצמת נחה ברשות מוריי ורבותיי, with the permission of Hashem, this week is the parasha of Behar Bechukotai. What it is the meaning of this parasha, Behar Bechukotai? There is two parashiot. One, it's the parasha of the Shemitah. The Shemitah, as we know, it's a big mitzvah that it was given to the Bnei Israel, to the Jews, on the mountain of Sinai. And Hashem, he said to Moshe to tell the Bnei Israel, when they enter Eretz Israel, they should do the Shemitah. They should not work their land. They should not make any kind of work on their land, just let the land abundant to the people, the fruit, they are for everybody, poor people, rich people, strangers, foreigners, can enter your land and just eat and take what they want. It's not a big, it's not an easy thing, huh? Just imagine somebody who abandoned his all his fields, full of fruits, vegetables, food, and he cannot sell them. They are for everybody. Anyone who wants them, he can use them. He can come, eat, take, and take what he wants. It's not easy. It's not easy. But this is just a mitzvah that Hashem he gave to the Bnei Israel. And that mitzvah was given to the Jews. It's written in the Torah, Behar Sinai, in the mountain of Sinai. So, there is a question. Is this is the only mitzvah that was given Har Sinai? All the mitzvot were given in Har Sinai. All the mitzvot were given to Har Sinai. So why only specifically this mitzvah? It said in the Torah that this mitzvah was given and Hashem spoke to Moshe in Har Sinai and he told him about the mitzvah of the Shemitah. 6 years you work your land, tell the Jews, 6 years you work your land, and the day of 7 day, like Shabbat, the 7 year, you should not work your land, let your land abandon to anybody. And that mitzvah, it's in Torah, was given Har Sinai. So my question is, the question that Rashi and all the commentaries ask, all the mitzvot were given to the Bnei and Har Sinai, not only this one. So, I think Rashi said, well, the Torah wants to teach us the same way that all the mitzvot were given Har Sinai, even the mitzvah of Shemitah was given in Har Sinai. This is the answer of Rashi. So the question is against Rashi is, do we have any doubt that we can say one day, we can tell one day that such a mitzvah or this mitzvah was not given Har Sinai? Of course all the mitzvot were given Har Sinai. Who can bear, which man can come and say that like all mitzvot were given Har Sinai, the mitzvah of Shemitah was given Har Sinai? I mean, there is no one who can speak like that. There is no one who can speak like that. So still our question is, why this mitzvah, specific mitzvah of the Shemitah, the Torah mentioned that it was given Har Sinai. I mean, something that we must understand. We cannot just let these words that we cannot let them go like that. My friends, you must know one thing, and that particularly mitzvah of the Shemitah, we need a lot of chizuk. We need a lot of emunah and faith in HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Don't forget, you cannot imagine somebody, you cannot imagine somebody who is a millionaire, who is making a lot of money in business, through his fields, his gardens, his lands, they give him a lot of business. For 1 year, he will let all this business going to everybody. It's not easy. So we need a lot of emunah, a lot of chizuk, a lot of emunah in HaKadosh Baruch Hu to respect this mitzvah. And that's why this mitzvah was given in Har Sinai. Because in Har Sinai, the presence of Hashem was in Har Sinai. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted to tell the Bnei Israel, look, my presence is here. The same way that my presence is here, and you look, all of you, you can feel my presence in front of you. So if you keep this mitzvah, that it's very hard to keep, my presence will be with you. I will not let you lose. I had a dream last week. It was an Arif Shabbos, I think. It's like somebody was asking me, why, Rabbi, this mitzvah, this particular mitzvah of the Shemitah, why the Torah mentioned that she was given Har Sinai? It's in my dream. It's a dream that I had. So I said, in my dream, I told him, because Moshe Rabbeinu, the first time he met Hashem, it was in the desert of Sinai. And he met him, the first time that Hashem talked to Moshe, he talked to him while Moshe was in Har Sinai, in the mountain of Sinai. And he told him, Moshe, when you come out from Egypt, you will pass through this place. And here I will give you the Torah. And then, from here, you will go to Eretz Israel. And I will give you Israel. So listen to this, please. That means that all the reason why the Jews left Egypt, there are two. One, to leave Egypt to receive the Torah, and the second, to enter Eretz Israel. Now, because Hashem give them Eretz Israel, give them Israel. But you see, this mitzvah of the Shemitah, that means that Israel, my land, that Hashem give me, it belongs to me, but once in every 7 years, during 1 year, the land, it doesn't belong to me. It's the Shemitah. Because all the fruit, all the vegetables, I have to give them away. So it's a problem. On one hand, Hashem give me Israel, and on the other hand, once in 7 years, he takes the land from me. Because it doesn't belong to me. So now we understand, Hashem, when he spoke to Moshe Rabbeinu about the Shemitah, he told him, Moshe, you remember what I told you? The first time I met you, I told you where the Jews will leave Egypt, they will come to that place and they will receive the Torah. And the Torah, it said, and this is the reason why I let them go from Egypt. Otherwise, there is no reason why I delivered them from Egypt. The only reason why I delivered them from Egypt is to leave Egypt and to come to this place to receive the Torah. And the Torah, there is a mitzvah in the Torah, that once it's every 7 years, the land is not their land. Because there is a lot of mitzvot that they are linked to the Torah. There is a lot of mitzvot that there is between me and Hashem, mitzvot between me and my friends, and there is mitzvot between me and the land of Israel, of the land. like to build a bit of mikdash, you know, there's a lot of mitzvot, teruma, the kohanim, their work, the shemitah, the yovel, there's a lot of mitzvot that you cannot do them here in France or in America, only if you live in Israel. You can work in America, you can work in Australia, you can work in wherever you are, but you don't do a mitzvah when you walk. But in Israel, in Eretz Israel, the Holy Land, every fourth steps that you do a mitzvah. Even that, if you need to sit in a chair, in Eretz Israel, you are doing a mitzvah. And if you walk, you do more mitzvot. And if you do Torah, you do more mitzvot in Eretz Israel. So you see, Eretz Israel, every second there, it's a mitzvah. Only by being there, it's a mitzvah. So you see, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he said to Moshe, Rabbeinu Moshe, remember, when you left Eretz Israel, when you left Egypt, it was for one condition, all the miracles that I did to the Jews, all what I did to the Jews in Egypt, only for one reason, that when they will leave Egypt, they will receive the Torah. And the Torah, there is a lot of mitzvot. Mitzvot between them and me, between them and their friend, and between them and Eretz Israel. So, that they accepted. And they said, Na'aseh v'nishma. Okay, so now, there is a mitzvah that's very, very hard to... now, that was the condition. So that's why Hashem, he mentioned to Moshe Rabbeinu, this specifically mitzvah that it's very hard to accept and to accomplish. It was given in Har Sinai. Its name is Shemitah. That's why this specifically mitzvah, Hashem, he said, the Torah wrote that Moshe Rabbeinu received this mitzvah Behar Sinai. And that's why there is another parasha. After this parasha, it's called Bechokotai. Bechokotai, it's laws that there is no reason. That means there is a lot of mitzvot in the Torah that we don't know why. Like, not to eat chazir. Why? We don't know why. Not to touch a woman that she's nida. Why? We don't know why. To study Torah. Why I have to study Torah? There is no reason. There is a lot of mitzvot that we call them chok. Chok. It's a law. I remember last week, I was in a car, and the driver, he forgot, and he entered a road, a one-way road, that he shouldn't do it. And unfortunately, opposite him, in front of him, was a police car. So of course, he made him stop. So the policeman, he told him, do you know you're not allowed what you're doing here? You're not allowed to enter this road. He said, no, I did not know. He said, okay, I'm sorry. He said, no, it's not you, sorry. You did something against the law, and you're going to receive a punishment. So the man, he said, but why? So what if I did it? So what? Why if I did it? So the policeman, he said, well, this is the road. This is the law. There is no entry. You have to respect the non-entry. So that may say, why did the city put there non-entry? So the policeman said, well, this is the law. We don't ask about law. Why we have to pay 10% tax, or why? This is law. I mean, this is a hook. Gzera, when the government decides some kind of laws, no one can say why. This is the law. You voted for them. That what they say, you have to respect. That's it. We voted for Hashem in Matan Torah. We say to Hashem, Na'aseh v'nishma. We say to Hashem, Na'aseh. We will do. Then we will hear. That means we did accept whatever Hashem he will tell us. So it's a law. Any kind of law, any decision that he will take, we must respect, accept. That's it. So now I understand. The Eretz Israel was given to the Jews, b'matana, a gift, since they come out from Egypt. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he said to the Bnei Israel, hey, Eretz Israel, I will not give you Eretz Israel free. I want Shemitah. I want this mitzvah. That was the condition between you and me. Before you were delivered from Egypt, I told Moshe to tell you that you will receive the Torah in the desert. Torah that there is the Torah that it's connected to you, to me, and to the land of Eretz Israel. And one of the biggest mitzvot, the laws that we're going to give you, it's Shemitah. That means Eretz Israel, I give it to you, but still I will not give it to you 100%. You can have it, it's yours, but once every 6-7 years, that 1 year, it doesn't belong to you, it doesn't belong to me. So always you will remember that you depend on me. It's very important for Hashem that we should depend on Him. You see, now we understand why this mitzvah was given in Har Sinai. Because the condition of to give the Torah to the Bnei Israel was said in Har Sinai to Moshe before he went to Egypt to deliver the Jews. So why did the Jews will not tell Moshe if we knew that Hashem was going to give us the land and then he would take it back once in a year, we would not accept. So this argument is off because they accept it. So now I understand the test, the big test. I would like you to listen to this. It was a big test of Moshe, of Avraham Avinu Alav Hashalom. When Avraham Avinu Alav Hashalom was in Haran, HaKadosh Baruch Hu told him, leave Haran for your benefit, le'ana'atcha u'tovatcha, and I will give you the best place in the world. But he did not tell him where. Avraham Avinu, he knows each malach, each angel who protects any kind of any country. Like America, there is a malach, an angel who protects America. There is an angel who protects Russia. There is a malach who protects France. There is a malach who protects the Arabs. There is malachim. There is malachim who protect their... you see, Benish Hai said that a Jew is not allowed to steal from a goy, from a non-Jew. Because a lot of people, a lot of Jews, they think not to steal from a Jew. But from a goy, from a non-Jew, you can steal. So Ben Ishai said, no, you're not allowed to steal to a non-Jew. Why? Because when you steal money to a non-Jew, so there is a problem. Why? Because the malach, the angel, protects the country of the non-Jew. They go to Hashem, they say to Hashem, Ribbono Shel Olam, my Lord, look, this Jew, he steals money from my people. So Hashem, he said, well, you can do the same to him. And what he does, the malach, the angel who protects the non-Jews, he steals all the mitzvot that the Jew did. Are you listening? Huh?
Yes, yes.
So, it's incredible. Did you know that?
I didn't know that, no.
So he steals from him all the mitzvot. So it's not worth it to steal money from a non-Jew. You know, the Chafetz Chaim, Alav Shalom, the Chafetz Chaim, one day he went to the post office to send a letter. And while he was going, there was a Jew who told him, hey, my rabbi, where are you going? He said, well, I'm going to go to the post office to send a letter to Vilna. So he said, well, he said, well, you know, I'm going to Vilna. I can take the letter. I will deliver the letter myself. So the Chafetz Chaim, he said, oh, thank you very, very much. But let me go and buy a stamp. So the man, he said, but Kvod HaRav, you don't need to buy the stamp. I'm going. I mean, I'm going to deliver your letter. He said, but this kind of work, it's only the post office can do it. And I thought that to send the letter by the post office. And now, because I thought that we'll send the letter by the post office, by not send the letter by the post office, I will make them lose the money of the stamps. So, thank you for your favor, but you can still do me the favor, but just I will put the stamp and take the letter with the stamp to the man to whom I want to send the letter. Look, this kind of people like Chafetz Chaim. From that story you can imagine how big was the Chafetz Chaim. So you see, so Abraham Avinu Alav Shalom, he was looking which this country that Hashem he want to give me, it's governor by which Malach. And he was looking. Then Hashem he said to Abraham, the country that you the place, the holy land that I'm gonna give you, I take care of her. It's not under control to any Malach. It's depend on me, only on me. Like the Torah said, Ine Hashem El Aritz Hazot Bereshit Hashana Ve'atzuf Hashana. Hashem he keep his eyes on the Holy Land from the beginning of the year to the end of the year. So you will never find which one who governed this country. Only me. There is nobody. So you see, you understand, Eretz Israel, the Holy Land, it depends on HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And this country, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, give it to Am Israel. He give it to the Jews. But even that Hashem, usually when you give a present to somebody, that's it, yes or no? You give a diamond ring to your wife, it belongs to her, it's not yours anymore. You give a present, you give a donation to somebody, that's it, it's not yours anymore. And so, HaKadosh Baruch Hu give Eretz Israel to the Bnei Israel. He gives the Holy Land to the Bnei Israel. So that's it, he gives it to them. But HaKadosh Baruch Hu give it to them only with one condition. Which condition? If they respect the Torah that depends on Eretz Israel. If they respect the Torah, they respect the Shemitah, they respect the Yovel, they respect Torah Mitzvot. Only this is, it's like I give you a land with condition. And that's what happened. When the Bnei Israel did not respect the condition, so the Eretz Israel was destroyed and the Jews went to exile. And the Gemara said, why the Jews went to exile? And the Gemara answered, because of they did not respect the Shemitah and they did not respect the Abadim. They did not give a full freedom to the slaves. Because they should keep slaves 6 years and they keep them more than 6 years. And they did not keep the Shemitah. That means this is a condition. Now we understand that HaKadosh Baruch Hu give a condition to Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe, I'm going to deliver Eretz Israel, the Jews from Egypt, I'm going to give them Eretz Israel. But one condition, when they come here, they will receive the Torah, and the Torah they will receive more conditions about the land that I'm going to give them. What conditions? That it's their land, but once in 7 years, it's not their land. It's my land. And once every 49 years, they have to give back all kind of land that they bought to the original people. Now listen to this, please. Mamash, I want you to listen to this. Look what happened. Abraham Avinu Alav Shalom, he came to Eretz Israel. When he arrived to Eretz Israel, you know what happened? There was no food. There was no food. There was starving. There was no food. So Abraham Avinu Alav Shalom, he saw this beautiful place, and he realized that Hashem, he is the master, the Baal Habayit of this place. It belongs to him. It's up to him, and he take care of this place when he land. That's why we call it Holy Land, because it depends directly to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And he said, well, there is no food. What kind of place HaKadosh Baruch Hu give you? It's like it was shocking. You know what happened? And Hashem said to Abraham, you know Abraham, go to Egypt, because in Egypt there is food there. So Abraham could say to Hashem, so give me Egypt. Why you give me Eretz Israel? You give me the Holy Land. You told me it's the best land. Okay, there is Kiddusha. But what? How can we serve you if there is no food? The place like Egypt that you say it's an impure place, They have food there. They have everything there. And what happened? Abraham had to go there. It was a very, 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 very big nisayon, a big test for Abraham. One hand, Hashem give him a present, but it's not a good present. It's not a good present. So why Hashem did that? You know why? HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted to show Abraham Abino that this place is the best place. It's a holy land. But not always it can belong to you. Not always can belong to you. When it should belong to you, you will have whatever you want, it's yours. During the 6 years. But on the Shemitah, it's not yours. You have to go out, get out from your land. It belongs to everybody. You understand? Now understand why HaKadosh Baruch Hu, HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted to start teaching Abraham Avinu that Eretz Israel, you cannot buy Eretz Israel easily. Eretz Israel, because it's so holy, you have to deserve to live in Eretz Israel. You have to deserve to live in a holy land. It's not for everybody holy land. You have to deserve. And if you want to deserve that holy land, it's yours. So you have to respect all the laws that they're up, that they depend on Eretz Israel. And beside this, it's a good present given to you, but once in every 7 years, it's not yours. Like Shabbat. All weeks, it's my week. But Shabbat is Shabbat Hashem. Shabbat belongs to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I have to stop working. I have to stop. All week I work, I do whatever I want, but Shabbat, I'm not in my world. Shabbat, I am in the world of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It's the Olam of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's why we say, Shabbat is Me'ein Olam Haba. Shabbat is like Olam Haba. What is Olam Haba? The Olam Haba is the place of Hashem. Hashamayim, Shamayim El Hashem. The Shamayim is for HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Ve'aretz Ata Livnei Adam, and the earth is belong to us. But on Shabbat, the earth it doesn't belong to us. We cannot work. Shabbat, it belongs to Hashem. The land come back to HaKadosh Baruch Hu on Shabbat. 6 days, it's your land. 6 days, do whatever you want to do. But on Shabbat, it's not yours. So if it's not yours, you have to get out. It's like you go to a hotel. You pay for 6 days, 6 nights. After 6 nights, during 6 nights, it's your hotel. During 6 days, it's your hotel. You do whatever you want there. You stay wherever you want. You use the water. You use everything. But after 6 days, it's not your place anymore. They tell you, sir, you have to get out. So this is exactly the meaning of Shabbat. Shabbat, it's Shabbat Ul Hashem. And Shemitah, Veshavta Are Shabbat Hashem. The Shemitah, the 7 years, it belongs to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It's not your land anymore. It's not your land. Then after I explain you why. Now it's all this, I give you all kind of introduction just to make you understand a few things. Now we understand. It's a big nisayon. That your land is yours 6 years, and the 7 years is not yours. It's a big nisayon. But if you are clever, you will understand that anyway, nothing is belong to you. HaKadosh Baruch Hu could tell you, hey, you are my guest all your life. So be happy that I give you the land for 6 years. And then after, not only after, it's not yours, but when you respect what I tell you, after 7 years, after the Shemitah, your land, it will give you triple brachot that you couldn't imagine. You couldn't imagine the brachot that you will get. So now I understand, everything started from Abraham Avinu. Abraham Avinu, alav shalom, he was the first one who passed that test. He came to Eretz Israel thinking it's the best. He saw she was the best. Suddenly, starving. There is no food. No food. So Hashem told him, well, you have to get out. Go to Egypt. There is food. Here there is nothing. It was a big desire for Abraham. Abraham could say to Hashem, Hashem, what kind of gift you give me? He did not say nothing to Hashem. He accepts. It's a hawk. It's a law. It's Hashem is the boss. Hashem is the boss. He accepts the law of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. My friend, this is the way we should behave as well. We have to follow the steps of Abraham Avinu. That HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us the land. But Hashem said, well, it's your land, but after 6 years, it's not your land. Hashem did not ask us, go to Egypt. No, you can remain in Eretz Israel, but not work your land. So the test, it's less than the test that Abraham had. But at least, we learned from Abraham something. I would like to tell you, one day, Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair, he was the father-in-law of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. One day he had no... Somebody, the Ganavim, they stole his hamor. His horse. So, Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair said to his wife, ay, 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 our horse is going to die by starving. So she told him why. He told her because our hamor, he only eats kosher. He eats only from the food we give him, that we took the maaser from the food. That we even the hamor of our people has been here, he eats it only kosher. Because when you live in Israel, you cannot eat anything without giving the maaser, 10%. You buy a kilo of fruit, you have to give 10% of the kilo to the levy, maaser. Why? Because whatever you must think that what you have, it came from Hashem, and you have to share it with somebody else. Share it with the ani, with the poor. That's why Hashem wants us to give 10% to the poor. Because why you deserve more than the poor man? Why you have everything, the poor man has nothing? So at least Hashem did not tell you that to give him half of all what you have. No. Take 49, take 90% for you, but give 10% for the ani. Give him a 10%. At least you should to realize there is Hashem. So Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair alav shalom was very, very sad. 1 week after, the Ganavim, they saw that the hamor, the horse of Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair, he doesn't eat. He lost weight and he don't work because he don't eat, he can't work. So they were afraid that she will die in the farms, so they let her go. So she went back to her house and she started to scream. And Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair woke up. He said to his wife, the horse just came. I'm sure he did not eat all week. Let's give him some food. Can you imagine that? If a horse, you give the hashpa, when a horse, he eats kosher. With a totally kosher. A horse is not, he has no brain, but when he get a good influence from the education, the same way you give education to the children, you can educate as well a horse. And the horse, if always he eats kosher, so it will become a kosher horse. It's like there was a rabbi who sold his horse, his cow, to somebody, to a goy, to a non-Jew. And the rabbi, always his cow, all week he was working, but on Shabbat he rested. So when the goy, he bought the cow, he bought a beautiful cow, he was working all week. And on Shabbat he didn't want to work. And the goy started to hit him, to smack him, to hit him. the cow didn't want to work. And on Saturday night he started to work, on Sunday he started to work. And after 1 month he came to the rabbi, he said, "Rabbi, there is a problem with your cow. Every Shabbat he doesn't want to work. I don't know what to do with him. And most of my job it's on Shabbat." So the rabbi said, I forgot to tell him something. He said, "What?" Excuse me, because when he was by me, I never let him work on Shabbat. That's why he doesn't work on Shabbat. So the rabbi went to his cow and said, "Hey, as long as you were with me, you respected Shabbat. Now you don't belong to me anymore. You belong to this man, so you have to work on Shabbat." And he started working on Shabbat. Can you imagine that? V'shavta aretz. HaKadosh Baruch Hu said to the people, the land, she knows that it's Shemitah. V'shavta aretz. The land, we do Shemitah. We do Shemitah. She will not, she don't want to work. So don't push her to work. So we need a lot of emunah, a lot of chizuk. Now, I'm going to reach, I have still 15 minutes, I'm going to reach to answer all the questions, because I need it, this introduction to make you understand something. You see, first, tefillah. You're going to listen what you never heard in your life. It's a little bit of Kabbalah. What it is tefillah? Tefillah is praying. People use the word tefillah every day. Let's take the word tefillah and split tefillah in two words. Tefillah in two words. Tav, pay, we put them in one hand, the right. We have left yud, lamed, he. Yud, lamed. If you put them all together, it's tefillah. And if we split them, we will have taf, yahel. Taf, yahel. What it is taf, yahel? Taf, yahel, taf. It's, if we calculate taf, it's 480. Tet, tav, it's 400. Pe, it's 80. And the taf is the gematria of Lilith. Lilith, it's the klipa, is the impure side. Lilith, lamed, yud, lamed, yud, taf, is altogether 480. Taf, it's a Lilith. Yud, lamed, he, it's a Lights. What's that light? Lights, it's when a man pray, he should feel light. Like we say, Ora, Torah, zo ora. Torah is the light. When you pray to Hashem, it's the light. At least you have somebody to pray. Oof, you feel, you have problems. A man who has problems, he feels comfortable. A man has a problem, a man who is depressed, he goes to a psychiatrist, a psychologist, and he talks to him. He talks to him, da 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 da, and they give him a medicine. We have problems. We need a psychologist. So tefillah, we pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we talk to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. The biggest psychologist is Hashem. We have a problem. Anyone who has a problem, he goes to a psychologist. To help him, he made him talk, then he feel better. What is this tefillah? Tefillah, we have a problem. We have Lilith, we have the klipa, we have the impure side. We want to put on us depression. We want to separate us from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. The klipa wants us to be far away from Hashem, not to believe in Hashem. There is no Hashem, there is nothing. Why have to believe all this? But on the other hand, if what's going to happen, a man without the help of Hashem will be depressed. He will be depressed. So there is a solution. Don't follow the impure side. Follow the pure side, the holiness, the Kedusha, Yahel, the Or, the light. So Tefillah, it's a, when you want to pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, there is two ways. Or you pray to Hashem, and you will have, you will give His misericordia. Or you will be to Hashem, and you will be close to Hashem, and you will feel Hashem. Or God forbid, your side will be to the bad side, and then you are the loser. So Tefillah is to pray. When you come to pray, you must know, or you pray to Hashem, or God forbid, during the time that you pray, the Klipa, the Satan will come. Usually, always, when we want to pray, all kinds of thoughts decay. Then the telephone ring. Always, we have something to do, we want to pray. This is Tefillah. Always, when we want to do Tefillah, there is a big tara. Oh, we can't wake up. Oh, it is this. Oh, we want to have that. Oh, we have to watch the watch to get out. Why the Tefillah is the time that you can be connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and to feel the light from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And exactly during the Tefillah, the Yitzhara came to disturb you. He will disconnect you from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. During the Tefillah, a man, he rectified. I mean, a man, he is mamash. He is, through the Tefillah, a man, Be'ezat Hashem, he will do that he will be face to face with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And to be face to face with HaKadosh Baruch Hu is not easy. It's not easy. Oh la la! You need these three levels to be face to face with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Like Moshe Rabbeinu, that he talked to Hashem panim el panim. He talked to Hashem panim el panim. To have face to face with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you need a lot of emunah, you need a lot of bitachon, a lot of belief, a lot of connection, a lot of Torah, that all your thoughts are only with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It's not easy. So during the week, it's not easy. Because during the week, there is always problems. There is problems during the week. Because during the week, you have to eat, you have to work, there is a little. So it's a work. So it's a big work. To be connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. On Shabbat you don't work. On Shabbat, by not working, so you did all week you've been working to be face to face with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So Baruch Hashem, when Shabbat comes, with the Neshama Yetira that you receive, Baruch Hashem, now they are face to face with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And now, the Tefillah of Shabbat, it's more stronger than the Tefillah that you do during the week. Because the Tefillah that you do during the week, there is always telephones, business, you are disturbed by here. So always there is a begam, always there is a, it's not a 100% face to face. It's always, there is always problems. But on Shabbat there is no telephone, there is no work, there is no problem, there is nothing. So on Shabbat, they are already face to face. And then the tefillah of Shabbos, it's going to do something incredible to elevate them higher to the high level. The tefillah of Shabbat. That's why we say Mizmor Shir Yom HaShabbat. There is no mizmor of any day of the week. There is no mizmor shel yom rishon. No. All why? Because Shabbat, it's the highest tefillah. It's made on Shabbat because as you should know, on Shabbat, already the work that you did during the week. On Shabbat, it's already done. You must do something. During the week, there is a tikkun. And when you do the tikkun during the week, even that you pray, it's always there is something mixed. There is always as a matter of fact, allow me to tell you this. If you see the Shmone Esrei that we have on Shabbat, it's not the same Shmone Esrei that we have during the week. The Amidah that we have during the week, we talk about money, we talk about illness, we demand a lot of things from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So always there is a lot of material on our tefillah during the week. On the weekday, there is always something mixed. So to rectify the tikkun, it's not very easy to be accomplished. And besides, to be face to face with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and to complete all this work during the week, it's not easy. Of course, we need a lot of emunah, bitachon, but on Shabbat, we don't talk about material. On Shabbat, we talk only about how to serve Hashem. Yismach Moshe b'matenat chelko. We want to be like Moshe, Rabbeinu, that all his ma'ala, all his highs, Moshe, he reached a high level, Moshe Rabbeinu, only through what? Only through, because he called himself a Eved to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So on Shabbat, really, there is a lot of emunah, we don't work, this bitachon, and the work is already done, and now we are face to face with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And don't forget that on Shabbat, this word is like Olam Haba, Me'en Olam Haba on Shabbat. So we're in Olam Haba on Shabbat. We're like in Olam Haba on Shabbat. Shabbat Menucha. It's incredible. So now, on Shabbat, the tefillah, it's all our tefillah on Shabbat, it's we call it ha'ara, because even that klipa, the taf, lilit, that she's a klipa, on Shabbat it doesn't exist. That's why we say Mizmor Shel Yom HaShabbat. That's why we say Shabbat Shalom. And that's why on Shabbat the limud of Torah of Shabbat has no price. And that's why on Shabbat we receive Neshama Yetera, because on Shabbat the klipa is gone. There is no, with the zechut of Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov, we mentioned the Avot HaKadoshim, that the tzara was in their hand, the klipa was in their hand, they control the klipa. So that we say Mizmor Shel Shabbat, because Shabbat is very, it's Shabbat Ul Hashem. There is no, the klipa has no shlita, the klipa on Shabbat. We should not give her the shlita. But if we don't respect Shabbat, so the klipa has full control of you, has full control. This is the avera, is very, very big avera. Now we say Miriam. It says Vatikach Miriam, when the Jews left Egypt. It says Vatikach Miriam Menivah et haTof biyada. What does mean Tof? Tof is the tambour. Tof is like an instrument of music, but Tof is Tav. Tav, Pe. Again, Miriam, she was a woman, and she took this instrument that it named Tav. Tav, it's a musical instrument. But that if you we calculate Tav, it's 480. It's the same gematria of Lilith. That means that Miriam, that she was a woman, she mentioned to other women, Shirul Hashem, they started singing to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and they sang to Hashem. It's a tefillah. Shira, it's a tefillah. They started praying to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Shirul Hashem ki ga'u ga'a. They started singing and praying, like we sing and pray when we pray. And then Miriam, she mentioned to the woman, hey, watch out your husbands. Be nice to them. Take care of them so they will not look at woman or the woman. Because any man who look at to another woman, he has a contact to Lilith. That's what she took Fatika Hatov. Hatov is she was mebatel. She was mebatel at the clipper in her hand. So you see the tefillah is so important, the tefillah during the week, to rectify the parts of him, that you will be complete, and to be face to face. But on Shabbat, they are already face to face. There is no work on Shabbat, because on Shabbat, your emunah is so high, so big. During the weekday, we need a lot of work, but on Shabbat, the work was done already. So when we do the tefillah, Mizmor Shel Shabbat, the tefillah of Shabbos, that it elevates them higher and higher to a high level, because Shabbat it's end of Shabbat. There is no end of the Kedusha of Shabbat. There is no end. Now, I would like to tell you a secret. Now we understand the Shemitah. The Shemitah is like Shabbat. But listen to this. The Shemitah, it's like Shabbat, because Shemitah, we don't work. We don't work the lands. But still, it's not Shabbat. It's not Shabbat only for the land. It's Shabbat only for the land, because we don't work, do any work on the land. But we can go to open shops, we can do business. So, while on Shabbat, it's Shabbat. When you do Shabbat, you're not allowed to touch Mokze, you're not allowed to do nothing. But the Shemitah that we call it Shabbat, it's Shabbat only for the land, but not for the rest of the business. All kinds of business you can do it all year. So now we understand why on Shabbat, on Shemitah, they are complete. But we need to make them face to face. It's our way. And how we make them face to face? By Emuna and Bitachon. On Adonai Shabbat, they are face to face already, because there is no work. But on Shemitah, because there is work, we work, only the land doesn't work. So when it comes to the Parsufim, they are complete. But when it comes to face to face, you need a lot of Emuna and Bitachon. A lot of Emuna and Bitachon. So we have three madrigot, three levels. We have the levels of Chol, Shabbat, and Shemitah, and the Shabbat is higher. It's above everything, the Shabbat Kodesh, because Shabbat Kodesh it's something incredible. Shabbat is it's completely your emunah v'tachon. It should be full to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. There is no work, there is nothing. It's only study Torah to respect Shabbat. So on Shabbat they are already face to face, and with the tefillah to do even more, to elevate them to a high level. And on the day, because we work, we touch makze, we think about business, so our tefillah, we should be very, very careful about the tefillah. That the tefillah, she will not go to the klipa, God forbid, to the impure side. But on Shabbat, no. On Shabbat, there is no work. So usually the tefillah should go to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. On Shabbat, there is nothing to think about, because there is nothing to do anyway. But on the Shemitah, you can work. So it's complete, but it's not face to face. So we have to make them face to face through Emunah Bitachon. And I would like to tell you this. On the Shemitah, the man, he stopped working. But he stopped working his land, but he doesn't stop working the rest. So, he needs to turn them face to face. And to finish, I would like to tell you what I was thinking. Something it's incredible. I was thinking a big secret of the Torah. I was thinking, if we take, are you with me?
Yes.
If you take the tefillah, I would like just to take tefillah. Let's take tefillah. Yud, the last word is Yud Lamed He. If we calculate Yud Lamed He, it's Gematria, how much? 45 is Gematria Adam. And 45 is Gematria Yud Kevavke Bimiloy Alfin, the name of Hashem. So here you have two sides, one against the other one. Here you have, on one hand you have Taf. Taf is Gematria Lilith, is the impure side. And Lehadil, on the other side, you have the name of God. Huh? When you come to pray, and you have the name of a man as well. That means when a man comes to pray and he wants to be connected, to connect himself to Hashem, the Klipa, the Tum'a, the Tzara, that name is Lilith, she will not let him. And this is how she will not let the man be connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. But put the Pe before the Tav and put the Tav after the Pe, what you will have? Pat. Yes?
Yes.
What it is Pat? Pat is bread. And what it is bread? It's Lechem. And what it is Lechem? It's the Torah. Lichu Lachmu Bilachmi. That means you can turn the Taf into the Pat. What is this Pat? Pat, you eat it. Ki Lachminu Him. What Kalev, he said to the Jews, that they talk Lashon Hara about Eretz Israel. He told them, why you are talking bad about Eretz Israel? You are frightened about those people there. Kilach minuhim, we can eat them. Later, the same way we eat bread, we can eat them. That means that the tefillah, the only way to be connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, it's only through the tefillah. Through Limud HaTorah. So the word Tefillah, oh, you divide it, you will find the Klipa and the name of HaKadosh Baruch Hu Le'avdil and the name of Adam, or the Tefillah, you will find there the name of the Torah, Tefillah, and the name of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It's up to you. So through the Tefillah, during the weekday, or the Shabbat, you can go high and you can do a lot of works b'shamayim through your tefillah. Or Chas v'Shalom, during the week you can do a bad tefillah, so all your tefillot go to the klipa, go to the impure side, and Shabbat too, if you don't respect Shabbat. Or during the weekday you work to Be'ezat Hashem, that to complete, you rectify, you will do the tikkun, to complete Be'ezat Hashem all the parts of Him, and you will tell them face to face, and then that it's only a preparation for Shabbat. And on Shabbat, they already complete the parts of Him. And what you need, only to turn them to face to face, because they're already there. They're already there. And they're already there. They're already face to face. And you have to use this tefillah to be like them, higher and higher. But as I told you before about the Shemitah, of course, they're already there because you don't work. But they're not. But they're not face to face because it's a work that you have to work to make them face to face. When Imunah and Bitachon, it's incredible, and I would like to finish. Shemitah, it's Gematria. If I take from Shemitah Yud He, no, excuse me. If I take from Shemitah Mem He is Gematria Adam, and I will take Shin Yud Ishai, then I will have Tet 9. with the quality 10. That means that a man, he receives a gift. Shai is a gift. A man receives a gift on the mountain of Sinai, where Hashem gives the 10 commandments. And through that, it will connect him to the 10 Sefirot. So the Shemitah, when you keep the Shemitah, you become a big man. HaKadosh will give you a present. What? He makes you connect to the 10 Sefirot. And that's why this kind of mitzvah was given Har Sinai. Why? Because, and it was mentioned in the Torah that it was given Haitzev. Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu was in Har Sinai. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu said to the man, to Adam, to the Jews, by respecting this mitzvah, it's a big gift. Because Eretz Yisrael, it's a gift that I give you. Eretz Yisrael, it's a gift. And don't think that you will lose by not working that day, that year of the Shemitah. Because during that year of the Shemitah, you will have another gift that you will be connected to me through the 10 Sefirot, high and high. So you see, and to finish all this with 1 minute, now we understand that a man should respect his parents, not only in their life, as the Torah said, even after the death of the parents. Why? Because one thing is normal. When you look at yourself, look at yourself, look at your name. Who brings you here? It's your father. It's your mother. So your presence in this world, it reminds you that your parents brought you to this world. So not only when you look at them, you should respect them. When even that you do not look at them because they die, you should respect them because your presence is because of them. If there was not them, you would not be here. So you have to respect them. You understand me?
Yes.
So the same of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you should have always a Kaved ita becha v'timicha ne Hashem. Respect your father and mother, I'm Hashem. Why? Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants to tell you, the same way that your presence here is because of your father, because of your parent, and that's why you have to respect them, even after their death. So what about me? What about me? Who give you the neshama? It's me. So you have to respect me today and tomorrow. That's why the Zohar Kadosh Alav Shalom, he said to the angry river, he said, Ben Yichabed Av Ve'Eved Adonav, Ben Yichabed Av, Kabed Avicha V'Timecha, V'Kumua B'Michla V'Mishteh, you have to respect your father and mother by giving them eat and food and drink. When they are alive, and when they die as well. And if you think once, as hapato minehu, and you think after the dead, after they die, you are pato, you're not forced to give them food. No, they have agav the meat, even that they die, it hayib bikarev, even it is once mentioned, even after they die, you have to respect your parents even more, yet more. Dichtiv kabet et avicha. You have to respect your parents. Even you have to respect your parents more than your life. Why the Zohar said, why after the dead, why? He said, the Ehu bara azib bara. If a man does bad things, he takes a bad way, he does a bizayon to his parents. But they abide kalana, and if that man goes to the good way, and he respects the mitzvot, but they that occur, he gives a big kavod to his parents. Because a man who dies, and his child. He does averot of this world. Bashamayim, the Shamayim, they will see that man, hey, they will make him ashamed. Look at your son, what he's doing. So this is the reason why we have to respect our parents even more after the death. Why? Because here, when you do Avera, your father is alive, no one knows about the Avera. And your father doesn't know that you did the Avera. But when a man loses his father, and that man and his child is doing Avera, Bashamayim, they saw the Avera that the child is doing, and they point out to the father, look, you saw what he's doing. And when a man, he gave a good Jewish education to his son, and he died, so Bashamayim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he respect the father, and he tell him, come sit next to me. So of course the Zohar said you have to respect your father, that he respected his father in this world. You know how? When Rabbi Shimon, he went to the grave and he talked with him, Rabbi Elazar. Rabbi Elazar was not a baby, he was a big man. He could tell his father, Papa, you want to go to the grave, you want to go to the Mehara, why I have to go with you? I don't want to go with you. The Roman want to kill you, they don't want to kill me. Why I have to come with you? But Elazar, he went with his father 13 years and the Mehara only to respect his father. Of course, Bishmon, now that he died and he is in the other world, of course he has a shvach, he has a kabod, and two olamot. There and here. There, because he see his Belazar, his son, carry on the derech of Hashem, and when he was alive, he was a tzaddik. And after that, of course, the other word, Rabbi Shimon alayhi shalom, he's more happy. The zachah libnin, that he had the zechut of holy children, ugizei kadishin, and the holy generation, zakanin inun tzadkiyah zakai libanei kadishin. What there is a big zechut, a big merit to tzadikim, that they live in this world, children. Holy children, the Gizein Kadishin, and the holy generation, Allah who it carry, for them there is a pasuk, whenever you see those kind of people, you will understand that those people are tzaddikim, those people, they represent HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and God bless them.